Palestine, for instance, we used to receive international aid of around $1.5 billion. This dropped actually to at least now half of that or less even. Actually, yes, we count on our neighbors, on the Arab countries. Thanks for some Arab countries like Saudis, actually, who are still helping us, actually. We need more support under the circumstances. We need more support from the international community. When I said that it's declined, actually, the international aid has declined.
When you look at what's happening today on a political level, obviously security and economics very much intertwined. The president's son-in-law has said that he wants to achieve peace in the Middle East, and he's going to put forward a plan to do just that. Do you have confidence that a plan from Jared Kushner or someone else in the West is going to actually solve this problem?
Actually, we always wanted to achieve peace with Israel. This is our inspiration to have. When we signed Oslo Accords back in 1993, it was an interim agreement, actually, at that time. It should have ended in 1999 with a statehood. But actually, this never happened. At that time, the Israeli prime minister was killed by an Israeli radical. So there was a second intifada. But remind you, at that stage, there were certain final settlement issues which were left to final negotiations. Now what happened with what they call the ultimate deal, which we don't know anything except what we see on the grounds now, actually. For instance, Jerusalem. Jerusalem was one final settlement issue. All of a sudden, Mr. Trump has removed the embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem. He stopped funding UNRWA, which was established through, the UN mandate. He stopped funding even some hospitals which are run by charities, Christian and Muslim charities in Jerusalem. So what we're seeing on the ground actually is not encouraging.